Hey everyone, welcome back to Better Biomed. Today, I have an interesting and ethical discussion I'd like to open up. I just got off the phone with somebody who has a downed piece of equipment because a manufacturer came in to do a PM on the equipment and the users had somebody else come in and install the equipment and they had the wrong kind of power running to the device. Now, mind you, this device was running. It was functioning. But the manufacturer came in to do a PM. They cut the cord and said, you can't use this device. And then they left. Now, here's where this is messed up. As a contractor, unless you are leasing a device and you have some sort of responsibility, as a contractor, you can refuse to do a PM on a device. You get there, you show up, the conditions aren't appropriate for use, it's not safe. You can put up your hands and be like, hey, this is not safe, you need to do this, this, and this, and let me know when it's done. But you do not have the right to disconnect the device and disable it unless there's an immediate threat. Like you can see evidence that there is a fire starting to happen. Just because it's the wrong grade cord, yes, it's not right, you don't have permission to change it. They own it. They accept responsibility for using it in that condition. As a contractor, OEMs are a contractor. You do a PM, it's a contract to come in and do something. You don't own that device. You were not paying for that device. You don't have permission to alter a device. You can put up your hands and say, no, I'm not going to touch it. But all you manufacturers out there, you do not have permission to alter a device unless there's an immediate threat of fire, to which then you have to go and notify the users before you alter it. You can't just go up and cut the cord and walk away. Now, I'm going to have more information on this in the future. And I am personally going to the site and I'm going to take photos of all of what happened. And if I see something that is really ethically messed up, you're going to hear it here. I promise. I've done it in the past and I'll do it again. Because ethically, contractors don't own the device. The medical practitioner accepts responsibility for always using the device in the condition that it's in. They always are supposed to check the safety of a device before they use it. Now me, when I go in and do an electrical safety, I check in a device and see if it's safe. If it's not safe, I can't just take the device home with me or cut the cord on it and be like, hey, you can't use that. What I can do is I can go up to the user and I can tell them, hey, look right here, this is messed up. Or, hey, this one here is failing a PM. I won't put my PM sticker on it. Or I won't touch it. If I see something that's physically damaged right off the bat, I'm just not going to touch it. I'm gonna take photos of it with my phone, and I'm going to go and I'm going to show the users, hey, this is over in your equipment room. It's messed up, man. I can't do anything with that. But I'm not going to cut the cord on it. It's not my equipment. It's amazing, the audacity. And supposedly, this is an OEM that came out and did this. I'm going to get more information on this, but you guys that are users out there, you own these devices. The manufacturer does not. Anybody that comes into your facility to maintain your devices only has the authority to tell you, hey, they can't touch it. They can't alter that device without your permission. In-house Biomed, however, is different. In-house Biomed does have some sort of responsibility since they're part of the same entity. And in fact, they're more like the safety wing of a medical facility. So in-house Biomed can go up and cut the cord on a device that is unsafe to use until it can be made safe to use. That's part of their core functionality as a Biomed, as an entity, is to make sure that equipment is safe. We can take equipment that's not safe and we can put it in our custody if you're an in-house Biomed. I'm a contractor now. I cannot do that. So guys, this is wild that this even happened. And I'm going to get more information on it. But I just want to let you guys know, if you own equipment, you're a part of an entity that owns equipment and an OEM comes in and says you can't use something, they can tell you you shouldn't use it. They can't tell you you can't. The responsibility is always on the user. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching. And let me know if you've ever seen anything like this happen to any of your equipment or if you've ever heard of this before. It's wild. It's absolutely wild. Thanks for watching, guys.